I guess.
Say hi, Ian.
Hello. Hello. Yeah, we sorry we don't have any intro music. I guess we can do the whoop 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 whoop. Whoop 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 whoop.
Yes, just in case anyone out there is curious, I am a little anime girl this week. I'm playing.
Yeah, now we'll get some views.
Huh? What?
Now we'll get some views.
Right, just make this the thumbnail.
Yeah.
Boy in kitchen talks to weird ghostly figure in the woods.
Right.
That'll, you know, clickbait him.
Yep.
No, I got some software to try. I was going to try to mess with Ian, but I forgot he doesn't look at me when we do the thing.
Right.
He's like, what is that picture of a bunny?
Yeah.
It was a bunny, but that was beside the point.
Well, you did surprise me because, I mean, usually it's just you in a dark room.
Yeah, this actually, I have the room very lit so you can see my mouth. Because it can go by volume or it can trace my mouth. And I didn't want to go by volume because I'm trying not to be too loud. So,
right.
But we were incommunicado, or how you pronounce that, missing last week.
Yeah.
Ian's computer went poo-poo.
Right. And right now it's a work in progress still. Plus,
yep.
I had to dog sit for my parents, so. We're doing it a little bit different.
Yeah, we just said fuck it and we're doing it live. Hey! Yep. Hey, it's Ben Thompson. He has an avatar of a girl too.
Oh yeah.
Non-animated
one.
No, his moves.
What?
Hi, Ben.
Oh, hi, Animu.
So
let's see. Yeah. my headphones are acting up.
Yes, Ben?
That sucks.
Are you broadcasting?
Yes, we are. This is live.
Oh.
Yeah.
Say hi to the people, Ben.
Hi to the people. Anime fox face.
That's right. Aren't I pretty?
No.
What? I'm totally pretty.
So, you don't like the schoolgirl outfits, man?
It's not a schoolgirl. It's like cheetah. I totally like got this app and I was like, this is gonna be awesome. I'm gonna surprise Ian, he's not gonna know. And then he's like, was that a picture of a bunny?
Yeah. Looks like a bunny.
So you don't like my avatar, huh, Ben?
Not especially.
No, huh? Well,
hold on a second.
How about now? Huh? How about now, brown cow?
I think the battery on my headphones is dead. Need to replace it.
Hey. Hey.
What?
Excuse me, princess.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy. See?
Hootie pie! Sup? Poods.
What does PewDiePie look like a zombie? Anyway. So.
It's gonna be huge. Huge! Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Yep.
Yeah, I was.
I had Rick and Morty, and I don't know what happened to him. Oh, hey, I'm Sailor Moon now.
That's
hey Ben, check it out. You like it?
Oh boy.
What? No, You don't like it?
Looks cool. Like somebody's having too much fun there.
Hi, puppy. Woof. What? Which dog's that?
Her name's Zoe. She's a black lab.
Oh, excellent. Hi, Zoe. Dog.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Now I look pissed off. Don't I? I look like a bitch.
Okay. Yeah, and also you look like an anime girl, too.
Yeah. So, like, yeah. Yeah. What's up?
Well, like I was trying to say...
I'm going to stick with this one. Okay.
I didn't know you guys were going to be live at the start, because I was going to invite my girlfriend to come on and say hi, but she didn't want to be on the video hangout proper. So.
Aw, I'm sorry.
You just tell her that we're not live, but we actually are.
Eden forgot to hit the button.
I want to keep her as my girlfriend is the thing. So.
Oh no.
Yeah. So. that's all right. I'm not going to be doing none of that.
Well, sorry. We just figured out how to get this going. So
it's okay, man. You could get your girlfriend on. All you got to do is just do this in front of the camera.
Oh boy, Ian. Ben's been on the show for less than 5 minutes. Don't make him leave already. That's my job.
Yeah, the drunken fox lady is telling me I need to leave.
Why am I drunk?
I don't know. Why are your eyes going?
Oh, well, I don't know. But so, hi.
You're like, I'm just a little bit drunk. Not too much. Just
I'm
most
just
of it.
A little tipsy. I was just a little buzzed.
It made more sense when you were Rick, because at least then, you know.
What? Yeah. So, back to the regular programming. Such as, hey, where'd your face go, Ben?
I went away.
Oh, you're just the animated girl that you drew.
Just like you.
No, I didn't draw this.
Well, did anybody really?
Yeah. Someone had to work on this, Ben. This has layers. Ogres have layers. But you wouldn't know anything about that, would you?
No, because I'm not an ogre.
Neither am I. So, anyway, let's catch up for a little bit. What's everybody been up to?
I was taking a nap till this animu girl called me, and then next thing you know.
Taking a nap? Well, you gotta be bright-eyed and bushy-tailed for your date?
Mm-hmm. I want to be awake for it. I mean.
Yeah, he doesn't want to be droopy-eyed like me. I don't know why. When PewDiePie did the reveal of his... He's like, open your eyes. Why are my eyes closed?
Okay.
Hey, Pat.
Well, why are you so tired? Did you, like, get up really early, like, 3 a.m. or something?
Yeah. That's why I started working in the studio, yeah. Actually, that's more when I had breakfast, but yeah.
Hey, Pat. Whoa. That was cool. I had a butterfly fly by my head.
Okay.
Well, looks like Frank's having fun.
Whoa, Ian's upside down.
What's going on with this?
So, we already explained that Ian had computer problems last week, and they kind of trickled over into today.
Yeah. Still hasn't got that power supply, or?
Well... The whole thing's a work in progress, apparently.
Yeah.
Oh, is he down on the motherboard? And
I don't know.
I'll try to explain it. I have to get a new fan for my heatsink for the CPU cooler. But I gotta, it doesn't have like a way to mount it exactly, because usually the fans have like their own proprietary like clamps or whatever attached to the fan.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And I was gonna put I have to reorganize some of my wires. I got my new video card, the 480 Asus Strix 8 gigabyte.
You got the Asus. I remember you wanted it.
Yeah. It was a pretty good one out of the different vendors or manufacturers or whatever you call them. Yeah.
Cool.
It's really big. It's got three giant fans on it, so hopefully my case will even be able to accommodate it. I might have to move some drives down and rewire everything, so I got to do that. I got to reinstall my OS on the SSD still, and then on top of that, all of that, I was going to try to put that LED lighting in my case. So it's like, I understand why it's so long for Jay to do that Terry Crews build.
Yeah, you got to make it functional then, pretty, bro.
Yeah, I know, but that's probably going to be the part for last, you know.
And what are you going to call this machine of yours? Chinese democracy?
Oh, there he goes.
Oh boy.
So what has Ben been up to?
Working on stuff, watching some classes on Skillshare.
Skillshare?
Yeah.
Is that one of the bundle thing you packaged? Or package that you bought?
Yeah, I packaged a thing.
That's right.
I bought an art bundle. It had like 3 months of pencilkings.com and like 2 months of Skillshare. And So I've been doing stuff with that.
Mm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I just installed FaceRig.
Yeah, I could tell.
How could you tell?
By the drunken fox girl looking at me.
I'm not drunk. I'm just a little buzzed. I'm good to go home.
I told you, Frank, you should have got an image of Ian and then answered it as Ian, see what he would have said.
He probably wouldn't even noticed. Well, like, I had the picture on, and I was talking, and then I realized he just had the phone pointed at the ceiling when I was on the phone with him.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, well, so he can't even see my ass.
Well, oh, nobody wants to see your ass, Frank. I mean, I hate to tell you.
Shit.
Well, the problem is I was trying to start the – I was trying to actually host the thing, so I was more – worried about that at the time.
He was trying to host from his phone.
Yeah,
I was trying to live stream, but when I clicked on, you know, the go live button, or the start Hangouts on air, it would just take me to the Hangouts page on the Google Play Store.
Yep,
it wouldn't actually open up the app. And I did try, because I was using Firefox for that, and I tried to use a desktop site or whatever, you know. So yeah, if I have to do this again, we're gonna have to, Frank will be have to host it again. But wasn't as hard as you thought it would be, Frank?
It was confusing. I'll say that.
Says the drunk fox lady.
Yeah, no. I'm just buzzed in the woods. Aren't I cute, though? God damn, I'm cute. I look sure, like Frank. I fit in your pocket. Hey. You know, I can hear Frank. You. My ears are like the whole size of my whole head.
Now, why do you have two sets of ears? How does that work?
What do you mean two sets of ears?
Because you got human ears down by your eyes, too.
Oh, it's mid-transformation.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Don't ask questions.
Whatever, furry.
Shut up.
Uh-huh.
Shut up.
So anyway.
Yeah. I was playing with this. I was thinking about playing with Twitch, but because a lot of guys, I got the pro version of Face Rig thinking it would have all the DLC. I was wrong. Because pro just means you can use it professionally on like Twitch or YouTube and like make money with it. So.
Money, money, money.
Yeah. But you know.
Money, money.
You live and you learn, right?
Uh-huh.
Yep.
So. Anyway. Now that we're all caught up, would you guys like to do the news or look at some battle stations?
Well, do you want to play some catch up? I mean, what have you been up to, Frank?
This is it. just a lot of work.
How's work been treating you?
Just shy of having overtime. We'll be coming over this weekend, by the way.
Yeah, Mom was telling me about that. She's working tomorrow.
Yeah, she called me and said, I'm working, but you can come over after. Or before, whatever.
So. Cool.
Yeah, so, yeah, there's that.
Cool story, bro.
But yeah, no, what have I been up to? Ian, I not a whole lot. Work doesn't leave me a lot of time for anything.
Right.
I come home, I eat, and I go to bed.
Yeah, I've been watching stuff on... I've been watching courses on Skillshare, trying to find the best one to watch and maximize my time. I saw there's like... It's funny, there'd be classes that are like, you know, 15 minutes long, and then there'll be classes that are like 7-plus hours. So it's like, okay. Try to say.
How odd.
Interesting. It's like they let you have, like, you could have a save classes tab, but, like, for lists and stuff, it's you basically subscribe to a list that they've already, you know, pre-set up. So it's like, well, what's the point of that?
Right.
I don't know. So, I don't know. It's interesting, though. There's lots of cool stuff on there, you know?
Right.
That's cool, man.
Right, Frank?
Trying to find, I emailed myself something, and it's not showing up.
I emailed you the news links, too, so you could screen share my news, too.
Oh, okay. Wow, you got a lot of stories in here.
What? It's four there, right?
Yeah.
That's a lot.
Well, the two are grouped together. Two
that's
links.
Numbers. Oh, there it is. I didn't name something right. I named it something different.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Also, send me the, did you choose some battle stations, by the way, too?
Well, that's what I was looking at. I had them, and I don't remember which ones were which. So I got to open them and go, this one, no. This one, no. Sorry.
That's okay. Well, when you find some good battle station pages or whatever, just email me those or whatever. Or you could put them in the... Hangouts. Like,
I do what, you know, I want. I'm a little fairy lady in the woods. You don't tell me what to do.
Yeah. You drunk little fairy lady in the woods whose mouth isn't even moving?
My mouth's moving.
Yeah, mumbling when you're drunk.
Hey, shut up, Ted.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Let me close this. I've got a few. Close that one. I've got two.
Okay.
But the one's kind of got a lot to go over.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's cool. So, we can decide out of this too.
Okay.
If you want, or if we're doing a news, you could always find another one if you're feeling funky, I guess. Okay.
So can you see this here?
Mm-hmm.
I can't. You can have to make me so I can look at on my tablet.
Wood grain with a cat.
Meow. It's Alex drawers from IKEA, but see, to stand out, I was going to show it a little example. There's like three or four guys. This has become a thing on Reddit now, where the Alex drawers have always kind of been a thing. People are like, look at this. But like, to customize them, this guy stuck vinyl that looks like wood paneling on his computer and on the drawers, and another guy sprayed plastic to dip on the drawers to give them a bright color that he can just peel off if he gets tired of it. So mm-hmm. I thought that was a nice touch.
That's cool. Yeah, I've been wanting to play around with plastic dip and stuff.
Yeah, it's. Oh, and he's got the SHP 900s from Philips. Really wanted a set of those.
Also, a cat.
He's got an adorable cat.
Mm-hmm. I don't quite understand why he's got that mini keyboard though. If he's got a big monitor in front of it.
Gamers, a lot of them prefer the smaller keyboards because they consider it more ergonomical to have your hands not be stretched out, even though it's only by the damn numpad and by the arrow keys. They think it's more ergonomic and faster. I don't know. But
Who are we talking about?
The I don't know if that's 60%, the smaller keyboard without the 10 key. He says, why has he got the big monitor if he's got that little keyboard? And I'm like, a lot of gamers like the little keyboards.
Yeah.
What kind of keyboard do you have?
I'm just kind of distracted by the...
You made fun of me for like ever, Ian. What do you have?
About what, your keyboard?
Yeah.
I just have a basic eliminated keyboard that's wireless.
Do you have a 10 key on it or no?
A 10 key?
Yeah, the number.
Oh, pad. Yeah, number pad, yeah.
Okay. And then this one here, check this out, Ian. You'll really dig this shit.
Are we doing the battle stations thing right now?
Well, yeah.
Yeah, I asked you. I need you to message me the link so I could, because I can't see it on the little phone from across the table.
Oh, okay. Hold on. Copy.
Don't copy that, Floppy.
Don't copy that, Floppy. My bad. I didn't hear that.
Okay.
Here's the first one that we were looking at with the wood grain.
See, I'm just distracted by the wood grain now because he's got it going horizontally on the shelves, but then he's got it going vertical on the computer, and then that desk has a different kind of green on it because it's more like a laminated floor.
What? No, the... Okay. All right.
Yeah?
Can you check it out, Ian? My guess, Ben, is if he did them the other way, it would be he wouldn't have wide enough pieces to do the like he did the tower there.
Mm-hmm.
See what I'm saying? It would take multiple.
Well, I mean, I understand the idea is that you're supposed to go with the green, but it's just distracting to me.
It gives you something to look at. It lets your eyes dance around the picture. It takes you all around a little trip.
I'm sorry, I just see the cat and go, kitty.
Yeah, I want to pet the kitty real bad.
Well, who does it?
Kitty, 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 touch it.
Kitty on your foot and you want to touch it.
Where do you go?
I don't know. It's your hangout. I figured you knew these things.
Oh, shit.
Nice. This screen's been frozen on my end for a while. Oh, boy.
Oh, well.
I think you broke Ian, Frank.
Yeah. Well, while he's broken, check out this badass Star Wars themed room this dude's got.
How exactly is it Star Wars themed other than the lightsabers on the wall?
Hold on. That's just the first picture.
Okay.
See? He's got the TIE fighter pictures on the wall. He's got this fucking, whatever the fuck that is. Got the Mandalorian shit on the lamps that also have lightsabers on the bases. He's got this these other I guess some spaceships here. And I mean, I don't know. I thought it was pretty dope.
Is that supposed to be like the cockpit of the Millennium Falcon?
I don't know. I think he just kind of went with it. Oh, he's got the Lego UCS Super Star Destroyer. Oh, and I knew the Slave One. I know that name. And see that he's got a little Star Wars shrine over here. Hi, Ian Adams.
Hey,
what's up?
My phone died.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Hi, Ian's forehead.
Yeah, what's up, guys? Hey.
What's up, man?
So, did you see the pictures?
Where did you message me it with my email or?
The hangouts.
Hangout. Okay. By the way, who's on the black screen?
What?
Probably you.
Yeah, I don't know why it still has on me on there again.
Yeah, there's two Ians in this hangout.
Oh no.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll probably. So we got two here?
Yeah.
Okay, let me look at the first one because I didn't even get to see that yet.
Okay, it's just one picture on the first one, I think, of like the desk with the cat.
Meow. Meow. Oh, okay. Oh, it's got a curved monitor, huh?
Huh?
It's got looks like a curved monitor.
Yeah. And Ben was asking why, if he's got such a big monitor, does he have a little keyboard? And I told him that they, think it's more ergonomical. At least that's what they say.
But then why isn't his mouse wireless?
Oh, bitch, bitch, bitch.
I'm just asking questions, man.
No, he's got, this is, like I said, a thing they're doing on the battle stations a lot more now. It's a theme. They, like, get vinyl and they stick it on the tower, on the fucking shelves.
Make it look like wood, huh?
Yeah, I think it looks cool. It gives it some added depth and dimension. Makes it feel a little more cozy, like someone carved it out and say, here, sit here.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what people said in the 70s when they put wood grain on everything.
Yeah. And I what? I want his headset. He's got that. Those headphones are like kind of cheap, but I've been wanting a set.
Right. Well, I know wood has good acoustic properties. That's why they use real wood, like headphones and shit. You know.
Yeah, false decks and shit. Yep.
Maybe it's good for the computer because it'll keep the computer quiet.
That's just a sticker, Ian.
Oh yeah. I'm not even paying attention to what I'm even saying.
No, somebody like they put, one guy wrapped his computer in the stuff like this, and a guy goes, "Oh man, did you carve that yourself? What kind of wood is that?" I go, "It's probably vinyl, dude." Dumbass. So anyway, the second guy here, you'll probably like the second guy. Do you like Star Wars, right?
Eh. Yeah. Okay. I'm not a big Star Wars or Star Trek guy. Oh. I hate both of them equally. Well, yeah. I don't hate them, but I just right. don't care that much, you know.
Okay, well, check this guy's the second setup here. He's got 6 monitors.
Holy shit, man!
With a racing chair, lightsabers hanging up on the wall. And then the monitors all move independently thanks to their wall mounts.
Yeah, you have some like swiveled up and swiveled down. Mm-hmm. That would make that makes me wonder if that'd be like a cool monitor if it's not just curved width wise but also height wise. So like if you have like a really giant one.
Yeah.
You know, it would be like that, you know.
Yeah, and then he's got like that accent piece in the back, because you know you're all about the LEDs. I figured you'd have a boner for sure for this setup.
Okay, well, I'm looking. I'm on the app that keeps telling me like use our app or whatever on this image thing.
Imager, yeah. See, now Ben said, "Well, why is this guy set up Star Wars themed if he's only got the lightsabers?" I said, "No, keep going." He's got like models and figurines.
Yeah.
Like, and you open up his chest and boom, it's like the entire Star Wars collection. The fucking books and shit. So, you know, and trinkets, as he says.
Yeah.
Now he's got those heavy duty monitor mounts, which are, God bless him for buying them, because I wouldn't do it.
Right, those must be pretty expensive when you get like up to 6 monitors and shit, you know.
Yeah, like what are those, like $100 a piece?
Well, like an arm?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's like more than a couple of the monitors put together, maybe, you know.
Well, he's got a couple Dell curved ultra wide, so I'm pretty sure they're not cheap either.
Right.
And then he's got a GTX looks like a water cooling and stuff. So he spent a lot of money on it, and it looks cool. I just figured you'd like the LEDs and all that stuff. It ties together nicely. And, you know, I'm all about multiple monitors. So.
Yeah. What do you think about those racing chairs? Because I'm thinking about, like getting a new chair, because my old one, the leather is starting to peel off where your butt sits.
I
sleep in a giant race car. Where do you sleep?
Big bed with my wife. Sleep in
a big what? No.
You know, the racing. See, as a car guy, it's just a bucket seat. I'm over it.
Right. Well,
Frank? Why don't you just sit in a bucket seat that's meant to look like your car?
Yeah. So I personally want like a Herman Miller or something that's made to be comfortable. But those don't look like they're very comfortable. Have you ever sat in a car for more than an hour? It sucks. So.
Yeah.
Because I drive home. I'm in a car for an hour twice a day. I get out. I'm like, fuck this. I don't want to do it. I've been at my computer for 8 hours. And I don't want to get tired that easily. So.
Right. Uh-huh. Well, I know a lot of like the tech YouTubers like. Jay and Barney Clay's like when you're you have like a racing chair or whatever, you know.
Well, yeah, and Jay, he doesn't even use his racing chair for his editing. He's got a mesh back chair.
Yeah, and what's crazy is those can be expensive too. Like, a lot of the like corporate offices will have those kind of chairs, and they're like $1,000 just for a mesh chair.
Yeah, I think his I saw on like Amazon for like $50 though. So his.
Oh yeah, so it's not like one of those.
Yeah, because well, it's got a headrest that's mesh too, and I've read all the reviews are like the headrest sucks. But because I wanted to get a Herman Miller or something, but I'm probably going to get something cheap to begin with because the chair I'm in now goes and like sinks to the floor every so often while I'm sitting at it. So
right,
but yeah, I figure this is a cool one to share. If I only had this guy's money, and Ian wishes he had this guy's LEDs. Well, because like, look, his mouse has LED. The fucking his Lego damn destroyer has LEDs in it.
Oh, yeah. If I could talk about that, actually, like with putting that in my computer, I was trying to figure out because I was looking up tutorials on how to even wire it into the computer, and you know, I might have to. What I'm going to do is like solder some wires together, and then I'm going to test it on a separate my older power supply to make sure the thing works and it doesn't fuck the computer up, you know. But I was trying to figure out a way of you know, like controlling them, because a lot of people just control it with like the same remotes I use for the LEDs in my room, which is an infrared remote. So you just have like the adapter inside the case too. But I was trying to look in ways my motherboard doesn't have like an RGB header or whatever. And I, what ultimately I was thinking about doing was just doing like a Wi-Fi thing, because I bought a Wi-Fi module a little bit ago just to test out to see how good it works. And so like, I'm going to try that for just inside the computer. And so then I could control it on the computer, even my phones and stuff if I wanted then.
Random Frank P, he did a thing on his, he modded, he had a pre-built from CyberPower. But he put some company made a LED thing that he put on the inside, and then he put his own inside, and it was like you said, it wasn't an infrared remote; it was some kind of different remote.
Yeah, but what I was getting to was if you had like a motherboard header, and you're able to have all the, like if you're doing like the NZXT system or whatever, then you could like control them all together into zones and shit, so it's like your keyboard where each is programmed on its own, and you could do sweeping patterns and stuff.
Gotcha. Yeah.
Yeah, but oh well, Wi-Fi I think is pretty cool, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah, those the older model NZX or whatever those things, the older ones, they took up like a drive bay, and it was literally like physical knobs.
Right. Yeah, right.
Those are probably the safest bet.
But yeah, I saw a YouTube video of a guy. He had the system was working with his video card and like the RAM and the case lights, and you know, like each had its own zone, and it was like he had it like animating sweeping across like you would with your keyboard.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
What do you think of the lights?
For fucking lights.
Right. You're not a big light up guy? Benjamin?
What, are you scared of the dark?
Oh, I thought you were frozen at first.
No, I
no,
I
just waiting for you guys to finish.
Finish. No, I enjoy light up stuff. My keyboard and my mouse light up.
Yeah. Oh, your keyboard does too? Yeah. Or your mouse does, I mean?
Yeah. Yeah.
Is that an RGB mouse?
Yeah. Yeah, they're both in the same pattern, but they're just like off a little bit because one's Corsair and one's Logitech. But they both do fucking rainbow, so it's the same thing. You wouldn't know unless you're looking at it.
Right. Yeah, I guess that's Strix card has RGB on it, so.
My motherboard has RGB, but I've got no window.
Don't. Hey, like I said, you could always, if you're feeling brave, you could always take an angle grinder to it and then get some acrylic.
Nah, oh, cool.
That reminds me too, like if I can't fit this video card in, obviously I'm gonna have to get a new case, which I was thinking about doing also. What do you think about the tempered glass craze now?
You mean like where this whole side panel is just a piece of glass?
Well, it's a tempered glass window. I mean, I think some are actually tempered glass windows, and I think some are the whole thing is just glass.
So you have a glass desk and you'd have a glass computer case.
Yeah. But I think for me it would be safer because I would have the computer is going to be on the floor, so.
I mean, they look cool as long as you're, you'll have to get your cable management up to snuff.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's what I was going to do, too. I was going to rewire shit and then, I mean, it's cable managed okay, but I'm going to do it a little bit more. I don't know if I told you I have to take out some wires because I had problems with the front USB thing where I had them plugged in weird because all the plugs look the same that you plug into the actual front
the header.
And so like I mixed them up and I think if the guy said because I took it in the micro center and the guy said it was they shorted out the firewire port or something, so.
Oh, yeah, wow, it has a firewire port?
Yeah, what's weird though, it's the firewire is in the back though.
Hmm.
So, yeah, but I don't care about firewire and I could live without my front USB things, you know?
Gotcha.
Mm-hmm.
So. Okay, cool.
But, I'm going to, out of these two, I would say that I do like the second one better.
With all the lights and the monitors.
Yeah. I mean, I guess this would be another case like the last time we did where the next one was like more crazy and stuff. So that's why I usually pick it, you know.
I enjoy the multiple monitors, but the other one, the aesthetic of just cool and relaxing. Plus, there's a cat.
Well, yeah, right, but you can get cats.
Well, that's true. I would go with the bigger desk so I could put more monitors. But
yes, but Frank, if you had monitors, you could get a big desk because desks are cheap. Monitors are not. A desk is a slab of wood, Franklin.
Yeah.
Just set a bigger piece of wood on top of the desk you got. You got a bigger desk now.
Yeah. Get there. Ben, which ones do you prefer, the wood panel or the guy with all the Star Wars goodies?
The one with six monitors, Franklin. I don't see how this is a question.
Let's agree to disagree.
Well.
Okay. So.
But you do like the whole vinyl thing, though, huh?
Well, it's different. It's because, like, you know how, like, battle stations have been going through themes lately. Like, the setups, you get those tile lights that guys hang on their wall. They're, like, $200 for just some fucking lights.
Yeah.
Or,
well, that's why I want to do my own LEDs instead of buying those crazy expensive LED strips that are made just for the computer.
Right. But this is, like, you know, vinyl that is, like, what, $10 a roll or something like that?
Right.
And they just stickers it to the fucking computer. And it stands out. There was another guy that had like one of those wood bamboo looking headphone holders that you sit next to your tower. So you go wood, stands out.
Yeah.
So it carries the theme out. Yes, Ben.
So he's got wood all over his desk, but then he's got carpet.
Well, you know, he might be renting. That's a champagne colored carpet right there.
Do you want to try a third one, Frank?
Mm-hmm. Do you have one?
No, I figure you'd just be able to get a third pull out a third one pretty easy. Just do one like at the top of the list of on Reddit or something, Battle Station.
Oh, just like the whatever's the top.
Yeah, I love that. Okay. You never know.
Well, let me look. I have my finger on the damn button and it goes, "You meant to hit that, didn't you?" And I'm like, "No." Let me go to my subreddit. And mm-hmm. just go with the there and then let's see. Top. The top. Oh, this one. Okay. I actually like this one.
Okay.
Hold on. This is the top one right now. Can you see it?
Yeah.
It's wall mounted. And he's got an Asus monitor and two fucking GeForce 1080 Ti's.
Yeah.
And a water loop Maximus Hero fucking board. Jesus. full specs, blah, blah, blah. But the reason I like this setup is because of all the Fallout crap he's got in here.
Of course you do.
He's got a little bobblehead on his desk. He's got the framed lithographs on the wall. And then he's got another set on the shelf behind him. So I said, someone's like, "Oh, I like the pictures on the wall." I said, "Fuck the pictures. Show me the bobbleheads on his shelf." Because I've seen this guy before. He had to post an Instagram of just his bobblehead collection. Because that whole wall is just Fallout merch.
Mm-hmm.
And he showed the picture of the collection and the fucking all the shit in it, actually. Let me go to the comments.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Power supply cables, blah, blah, blah. Cable sewing.
That tower isn't too bad. I guess I'm not, like, a big fan, though, of the, like, the really crazy, bulky computer towers, you know?
Yeah, the Fantex. See, this guy has all the bobbleheads I got. I think he's got the 5-inch ones, though, because I've got the 7-inch ones, and these seem a little smaller, which is what I should have did. Oh, well. You live and you learn. Right?
Right.
I like the whole setup. I mean, the coloring he's got for the, you know, the theme for the actual computer.
Yeah.
It matches his keyboard and mouse. And then everything else is kind of black and gray, you know.
Right.
You don't even notice his old MacBook he's got there. What do you think, Ben?
Mm.
You don't like the looks?
Looks nice. Looks nice. Doesn't look as powerful as the thing running 6 monitors, but you know.
Well, it could. It's got two fucking Titan, or yeah, two 1080 Ti's. So I mean, they're it's beastly.
Did you see Dave's rant about
the
new
one already?
Oh, go ahead, Ben.
Just saying, the other one already has 6 monitors, and they're mounted to the wall with arms. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, but well, he's got a whole shelf of Fallout toys.
Frank liked his toys, huh?
Yeah.
I think what Ben's saying is, if you had the computer tower and put it with the other guy with the 6 monitors, that would be really good. Then, you know, that's what.
Yeah, I didn't even see the other guy's tower. I like that tower. It's got a nice color scheme, and you know, looks all right.
Yeah, does that look like a? Oh, not that one, but the computer tower. That looked like an IKEA desk, wasn't it?
What? This one? Or the...
Yeah, that one. That those like they have those white IKEA desks or whatever.
Yeah, that's what I was. This is actually what I was wanting to get. The other guy that would set up the first one. This is actually what he has. It's just he put that vinyl on the drawers. I mean.
Okay.
So it's, you know, Plus, those speakers are pretty fucking expensive right there. And this dude's got the same tower I have, except he's got a window. But I'm not about the window. I ain't living that window life, son.
That's another guy, though, that was...
And see, that's the tower right there that we were just talking about, that Fantex. Yeah. That's the same one.
That's the first one.
Well, see, yeah, but I'm saying, though, it's the same one as the guy with the wall-mounted one. It's just the vinyl, it looks different.
Right.
Okay.
Well, I would probably say the monitor guy first, tower guy second, and then vinyl guy third.
Ben?
Yeah, I'd go with Ian so far.
See, I would pick the monitors last.
You would, huh?
Yeah, even though I've got three myself.
You're saying you like you some $10 vinyl, huh?
It speaks to me.
Faux wood speaks to you, huh?
I like the bobbleheads better, but you know, if I'm buying it for the desk and the computer, you know.
Frank likes that wood.
Inglewood always up to the good. Okay, so.
Nah, he's just going for the cat. That's all it is.
That too. All about the pussy. I also haven't had a chance to ask Ian. I don't have a song this week for it, but I'm probably going to get one. Have you seen Pulp Fiction yet?
No, I have not.
Well, you're going to get a goddamn song like I had Ghostbusters, so don't worry. So,
okay. Yeah, maybe I'll check it out this tonight then.
You better.
I don't have nothing to do.
Okay, so are we ready to talk the news?
Yeah, might as freaking well.
Sure.
Okay.
No. The news with Ian.
I'm going to start off with my story because it's the first one I have a tab for and it's open, so.
Okay.
At least three states are trying to replace the online privacy rules nixed by Trump. Local lawmakers are exploring how to change the way internet providers collect and share users' information. Let me see, how long is this? I can read most of it here. It's short. Now that President Donald Trump has scrapped online privacy rules imposed on the likes of AT&T, Comcast, and Verizon, some advocates who seek greater protection of consumers' personal information are turning their attention to the states. Lawmakers in at least three capitals, Maryland, Minnesota, and Montana, are weighing new restrictions on the way internet providers and other companies can collect and share their customers' sensitive data, including their web browsing histories, with advertisers. Under President Barack Obama, the Democrat-led Federal Communications Commission in Washington last year advanced rules that would have required broadband providers to obtain customers' permission before selling their information. But Republicans in Congress voted this month to scrap the FCC's previous order, and Trump signed the measure on Monday. Let me get to the part here. For now, that's why she and others are trying to focus on the states and make sure they're crafting good, solid legislation that will survive a challenge. So, yeah. What do you guys think of that?
Eh, we're boned. We knew it.
Ian?
Yeah, I'd probably say the same thing. Yeah.
I mean, at least some states are trying to do something. That's better than nothing. So, okay.
Yeah. Well, this new guy, what's the FCC's name under the Trump administration now?
Well, the guy that is against net neutrality?
Yeah.
I can't remember.
I read an article about him on Wired, and they were just like, you know, the stuff he's saying doesn't really make much sense, but whatever.
Okay. Here's another ad. Not an ad. Hold on. Let me go to some of Ian's stories here just to mix it up.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, you could just do the screen share. Let me open on mine.
I'm going to start backwards. I'm going to do your WikiLeaks first.
Okay. Okay, so
WikiLeaks just dropped the CIA's secret how-to for infecting Windows. This is your store, right?
Yeah. WikiLeaks has published what it says is another batch of secret hacking manuals belonging to the U.S. Central Intelligence Agency as part of the Vol 7 series of leaks. The site is billing Vol 7 as the largest publication of intelligence documents ever. Friday's installment includes 27 documents related to Grasshopper, the codename for a set of software tools used to build customized malware for Windows-based computers. The Grasshopper framework provides building blocks that can be combined in unique ways to suit the requirements of a given surveillance or intelligence operation. The documents are likely to be of interest to potential CIA targets looking for signatures and other signs indicating their Windows systems were hacked. The leak will also prove useful to competing malware developers who want to learn new techniques and best practices. Grasshopper is a software tool that is used to build custom installers for larger computers running Microsoft Windows operating systems. One user guide explained, an operator uses the Grasshopper builder to construct a custom installation executable. The guy continued. Yeah, the operator configures an installation executable to install one or more payloads using a variety of techniques. Each payload installer is built from individually configured components that implement part of the installation procedure. The operator may designate that installation is contingent on the evaluation of the target environment. Target conditions are described using a custom rule language. The operator may configure the tool to output a log file during execution for later exfiltration.
Yep.
There's a lot of reading to this article.
Yeah, yeah. If you feel that's all I'll probably read.
So
you get the gist of it. It's fucked.
Benjamin.
By the way,
so why did WikiLeaks decide to leak this?
Well, they're WikiLeaks. Why do they need a reason?
Well, they usually do stuff in reaction to something, don't they?
Usually, but I'm not like I wasn't sure like what the reason for the Vol 7 leaks were. You know, I don't know that. But this is part of it.
Gotcha. Yeah, just one more way that we're all hosed, Tommy.
Yeah.
Well, let me put in one of mine now to mix it up.
Oh, yeah. By the way, Frank, I was just curious, what screen are you, like, presenting right now? Because it usually indicated, like, if there's a white box around one of our screens, that means that we're on the screen currently in a broadcast, or if you have it like clicked again and there's no white box and it just goes to whoever's talking.
Well, whoever's talking.
Okay. Just making sure. I wasn't sure if it was just like I'm Ben the whole time, just like staring blankly into the camera.
Well, now that you just told me that, I'm going to do that.
It looks like he's, what are you laying down on?
A live cheater. Or,
oh, you know, just in bed, thinking about stuff.
Well, it looks like he's laying. What, he just got the phone on the table or something?
No, I've got my iPad in the case I have. It's got a little pillow thing, so I can just sit and watch it.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so here's my
go article. Ahead, Frank.
YouTube won't put ads on videos from channels with fewer than 10,000 views. Updated.
Oh, I saw that. I wanted to talk about that.
Yeah, we're not going to get any ads. Great.
Oh, well then, we can say all the curse words we want.
We wasn't going to get any fucking money anyway.
Yeah.
Fucking fucks.
I know.
Here, okay, hold on. How long is this article? Yeah, I'll read part of it. YouTube has come up with a new restriction on who can make advertising money off of the online video platform. The company announced in a blog post that started today, it will not serve ads on videos produced by channels with fewer than 10,000 total views. That means any new creators looking to be on the YouTube Partner Program will have to wait until they accrue 10,000 total views on videos on their channel before they start showing ads and collecting revenue. YouTube's Partner Program began when the site was in its infancy. Creators who joined it to monetize their videos work with YouTube more closely to make better content and receive general advice about creating videos online.
So is it retroactive or is it only for new channels?
Oh, I don't know. Over the past few weeks, Google and YouTube have been putting systems in place to rebuild the advertisers' confidence in the online video platform. Companies pulled ads from YouTube in droves after multiple reports showed some ads played over offensive content that included hate speech, white supremacist views, anti-Semitic jokes, and more. So,
yeah, that could get into my next article, which was about the advertisers not wanting to have their ads on, you know, like the hateful things, videos, and it's crazy because it's like a push and pull because the advertisers are like, we want more ad-friendly videos, and they're yelling at YouTube, they're boycotting it and stuff, but then the creators are like, it's too vague, taking money out of our pockets because then we can't make money out of our videos. You know, if we're just talking about something controversial, then the ads, we get demonetized and stuff. So right. It's just like a tug of war with YouTube, you know.
The update says a YouTube spokesperson told ours that the changes to the YouTube partner program announced today were put into motion back in November of last year with the goal first and foremost to protect creators. So I'm not quite sure if this is retroactive or just everybody knew or just what, Ben. I don't know. I'd have to look further into it. But your thoughts, Steven Universe?
Oh, thank you. Well, if you understand the situation, well, I mean, really, it's a sign that, you know, their ad revenue has been going down the crapper anyway, because, I mean, AdSense doesn't give anybody anything, even if you do have a good amount of views. I mean, the idea is that, you know, these are for bigger channels that are on the, you know, networks and stuff that are pulling in that kind of... So the advertisers want to have ad-friendly content, which makes sense if they're putting that much money into it, because, you know, try being a smaller channel and just, like, having to go out and find, you know, sponsors for your channel. It's like, this is, you know, still the best deal that those people are going to get, because YouTube, if you sign up, you can run ads. But the problem is now it's like, well, you have to have 10,000 views at least to even become a partner. But then again, like, Twitch was doing crazy stuff with partnerships and stuff, you know, how many you had to have and in order to get a partnership. And, you know, Blip was doing the same thing before it went under. So I don't know.
Yeah. Well, it's,
I don't know.
My article was about YouTube's latest advertising scandal is threatening to tear the entire community apart. The website's biggest stars
are tearing us apart,
warned.
YouTube.
Which story was this one?
The first one on my list.
Okay, hold on. The YouTube stars joined forces to fight advertising policy change? That one?
Yeah.
With a picture of PewDiePie.
Yeah.
PewDiePie.
It says YouTube came under fire after advertisers learned their products were being flagged, I'm sorry, as racist. As a result, several big companies pulled their branding from its videos and force YouTube to rethink its entire advertising structure, including how content creators are paid. But several YouTubers have revealed that their videos are no longer earning good money, making it almost impossible for them to justify spending many hours it takes to create videos the site relies on. The problems began after the Wall Street Journal published an investigation which found Coca-Cola and Amazon adverts on 5 videos in which the narrators expressed racist opinions. It prompted Alphabet, which owns both Google and YouTube, to change the way it places adverts. But several high-profile YouTubers believe that this change in structure is a way to get rid of any content that doesn't suit advertisers' taste and replace it with bland, family-friendly materials. So pretty much like censorship. But yeah, like a lot of companies like Coca-Cola, Amazon, I think McDonald's and stuff too. I mean, yeah, it's just crazy. Like a lot of people their videos are becoming demonetized without, you know, like an email or like a clear reason why or whatever. And, you know, like they really don't know why. And like the whole appeal thing is like a joke too, you know, and you can't call anybody. So, like, the thing with the giant YouTubers is that they do have some, a lot of times they have some kind of pull or some way of getting in contact to be able to get the thing fixed with YouTube, but a lot of the smart people, like, there's not much they can do, you know?
Yep. Ben?
Mm-hmm. I mean, what's there really to say? YouTube's been horrible about communicating with people because it's all automated and nobody's really doing anything, so.
Yeah, if you're just a... If you got brand name advertisers that are going to want control over their content, then the content is going to suffer. But if you just have people just doing to do, like you and me...
Well, I mean, it's a difference between YouTube and, like, you know, Newgrounds, where it's like, if they try and make, you know, advertisers don't want to go to Newgrounds because there's all kinds of unfamily-friendly and mature content up there, and it's like, well, what do you do with it? You know, it's like, you want to have the creative freedom for the people making stuff, but at the same time, it's like, advertisers don't want their stuff in front of. So.
Yeah. And, like, a lot of people, they're like, it's just something controversial, like, maybe like slightly controversial, and then they get demonetized, like that one guy that does the Jorg Sprav or whatever, that the Slingshot Channel guy that a lot of the, like a video guy hit, he got like demonetized or whatever on one of his videos, so he was like worried about that, but I guess he got it cleared up now. Yeah, like anybody like talking about, you know, like trying to tell people if like you need to get help because you're like suicidal or something, you know, if you have like talking about depression, any like anything that's like not happy, you know.
Yeah.
So pretty much any news thing is going to get demonetized.
You would figure you got to be edgy to get views, but then if you get, you know, views, and they're like, oh, well, you're too fucking edgy. Okay.
Oh, well, look. It's like, how many car companies want to advertise in front of the, you know, the car crash compilation videos?
Right.
I mean,
yeah, that'd be bad. Okay. Marvel is wrong about diversity killing its comics. What? Mm-hmm. This is your story, right, Ian?
Yep. By the way, did you email me? I don't think you emailed me yours yet.
I was just going to email you everything in one email.
Okay, it says, when it's time to blame someone, go for anyone who isn't a straight white man. At least that's what Marvel did with its statement about how diverse characters are driving down their comic sales. According to an Entertainment Weekly report, Marvel's vice president of sales, David Gabriel's, says what we heard was that people didn't want any more diversity. They didn't want female characters out there That's what we heard, whether we believe that or not. I don't know that that's really true, but that's what we saw in sales. Based on our own research, he's right. It's definitely not true at all. But it's not on gender diversity to blame. Gabriel also points the finger at racial diversity for a real 1-2 punch. We saw the sales of any character that was diverse or character that was new. Our female characters, anything that was not a core Marvel character, people were turning their nose up against. That was difficult for us because we had a lot of fresh, new, exciting ideas that we were trying to get out, and nothing new really worked. As goes on to say, it's true that Marvel comics haven't been selling so well in comparison to other publishers. In February 2017, only 2 of the 10 highest selling monthly comics were Marvel titles, and Marvel has been introducing and reviving numerous diverse characters. That is, non-straight white male characters in an attempt to appear less dedicated to preserving the status quo. Right now, Sam Wilson has taken up the shield in name of Captain America, placing a black male hero in the role of one of Marvel's most emblematic characters. Similarly, who could forget Kamala Khan, a Pakistani-American Muslim girl, and a new Miss Marvel, or the queer Asian-American heroine Cindy Moon, the latest introduction to the Spider-Verse, or to Nahisi Coates, Brian Stiefries's Black Panther, and its Roxanne Gay Pan spin-off World of Wakanda. That's a lot of things in a relatively short amount of time. So the reason Marvel isn't selling as many comics as before, assuming there's a current assessment, must be those darned diverse characters. Any fan can accept trans-dimensional travel or shapeshifters from outer space, but the idea that women or people of color can also be good as fighting is a rainbow badge too far right. But it says apparently not. Comic book researchers have crunched some numbers and found that the Mighty Thor star Jane Foster as the Goddess of Thunder, a Marvel second highest selling superhero title. Likewise, Invincible Iron Man, who stars a black teenage girl, ranks amongst Marvel's top 10 bestsellers under Ta-Nehisi Coates' authorship. Black Panther became the top-selling comic book of 2016. Not just the top seller among Marvel comics, but the top seller, period. Marvel isn't... Maybe it isn't diversity that's a problem. So... I don't know if you guys... I know... Frank, you said you're a big fan of the, like the Wolverine and stuff. Mm. Which, by the way, I did check out that Logan movie. That was pretty interesting.
It's a different thing.
Yeah. But what do you guys think?
Well, I mean, saying diversity is killing comics is kind of... there's all kinds of ways to say that's stupid, unless your entire core audience is angry white men. I mean, it's the same thing with, you know, Star Wars. You know, you get people bitching on forums. Another movie with a woman lead. It's like, oh yeah, we only had how many dudes heading Star Wars movies? Damn, dude, it's only the second one. Shut the fuck up.
Well, I've always been a believer that, like, the comic book... The comic book people, they can write good stuff, but then the suits, the guys in charge of the movies and the comic books, don't really know what the fuck the people want, because how long have they been giving us shitty superhero movies that aren't even close to what we actually want? So,
right. Well, it's just crazy, because a lot of times between the comics and the movies, you know, a lot of characters like the Kingpin or whatever will go white to black, then back to white or whatever, and it's just like so confusing, you know?
Yeah, I think Kevin Smith even said that, like, now since, like, Netflix is doing so well with their, you know, superhero thing, and, like, all those other different ones that are actually really close to the book, you know, they're more like, now it's, you know, actually taking the writers and shit straight from the comic books because they realize that they're doing so well.
Right. Well, I don't know, like, it's like, can't you just kind of, like, keep, like, the original characters original, and then, you know, like, you could have the diversity with making new characters, you know?
I figured the whole thing was stupid right when they did Smallville, no tights, no flights.
Yeah.
It's like, yep. Okay.
Like, I like the Black Panther. He's a really cool character, and there's a lot of other characters that I can't think of that I like. It's just, I don't know if I'm a fan of the characters that they changed, or, you know, like, from what they were, you know?
Well, it's like, you know, if they roll out a new character, it's not gonna sell as well as an established property. I mean, you know, it's like, how many of the Wildcats characters can you guys name? You know, it's like, you know, people know Superman, Batman, and maybe Green Lantern and the Flash, you know, and Captain America now and Iron Man, stuff like that. But it's like, you know, if they just roll out new properties, it's not going to work. They need to, you know, audiences are buying their books because they know those titles. Mm. So,
okay. Well, let me go to one of my articles that I think I actually had for last week, but I want to share it because I figured Ian's an Adobe fan, right?
Yep.
Okay. Did you hear about the Adobe algorithm that transfers one photo style onto another?
No, I did not. Go on.
Yes. They give examples. They take two photos that are completely different, and then it kind of combos. Like how, I don't know if you can see on my screen here, there's a picture of a bunch of skyscrapers, and then a bunch of skyscrapers at night, and then it turns the first picture into basically the second because it illuminates everything. Or this picture here where there's a nice, you know, scenery here, but everything's white, and there's this other scenery where everything's green, and it basically turns the white scenery green. So that's just the examples I've seen. Two pairs of researchers from Cornell University and Adobe have teamed up and developed a deep photo style transfer algorithm that can automatically apply the style, read color and lighting, of one photo to another. The early results are incredibly impressive and promising. The software is an expansion of the tech used to transfer painting styles like Monet or Van Gogh to a photograph like the app Prisma. But instead of a painting, this program uses other photographs for reference. This paper introduces a deep learning approach to photographic style transfer that handles a large variety of image content while faithfully transferring the reference style, says the rather technical abstract of the deep photo style transfer paper. Put more plainly, when you put in two photographs, the neural network power program analyzes the color and quality of light in the reference photo and pastes that photo's characteristics onto the second. This includes things like weather, season, and time of day. Theoretically, a winter's day can be turned into summer or a cloudy day into a glorious sunshine. So, yeah, here's like examples. The original photograph and then this reference photo at night. And then they turn the first photo into a night photo.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, I mean, it's a, yeah. I just figured, you know, Adobe, you know, is always doing stuff to try to be creative. And this is outside of the box stuff here. It's, you know, it's one thing to do composite of like taking pieces and putting it together, but to just say, you know what, let's make it look like this and then not even have to really think about it.
Right.
You know? because Photoshop alone takes forever. This right here, you just plug it in, and it turns it into the other fucking drawing. So.
Yeah, well, the problem with that type of stuff is like, you know, like, a lot of the, like, if you're trying to sell that, like, you could use pictures that, or like, I don't know what I'm saying, like, they could use pictures that they know for sure would work with their algorithms, so, like, right. You'd almost this code around your, you know, like, your advertisement pictures, and...
I'm sure there's a formula that always works, just like in music, where they're like, these three kinds of chords always work together, you know, these kinds of pictures always work well with these other kinds of pictures.
But then when you actually go to try something, like, complicated or whatever, you know, it ends up looking like crap.
Yeah, well, I mean, they lit up a dark, you know, skyline. I think that's pretty impressive.
Yeah.
So
I'm just saying, Benjamin? Hopefully it works like it's intended. That's all I'm saying.
Right. I mean, it's early now. It's still, you know, these are just like, what do they call it? Concept, I guess, because it's not out there for us to do anything with.
Prototypes and testing. Yeah.
I imagine this being a not a brush, but like something you can implement in later versions of Adobe. You have a Adobe Suite, don't you, Ian?
Yeah, I do. I have the latest one before they went to the cloud, you know. So,
oh, yeah,
well, you know, they had that content-aware scaling that came out, and like this is, you know, more of a thing. It sounds more like a Snapchat filter kind of thing, you know, where it's
yeah.
You know, combining stuff. But
Max. Yes, man.
I just figured this would be
what?
This would be interesting.
Yeah, I mean, like, they have had similar things like that before where, like, you take two pictures and then, like, combines them together in a different way, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But, like, this is unique as far as it's taking the style from it, you know?
Right.
Did you guys ever play around with that one thing where you can type in like a question or whatever, like, what would PewDiePie look like with the dog body of a dog or whatever, and it'll feed it through an algorithm and it'll like Photoshop the pictures together.
No, that's
I forget what that's called.
I know what you're talking about. No, I've never tried that.
Yeah, well, I tried to do it myself, and I couldn't. I think. You had to download like a special app or something for it.
Okay, now I'm going to go into another Ian stories.
I have more.
How many more stories do we have?
It looks like Ian has two and I have one.
Okay, because my girlfriend was wanting to come in and say hi to you guys after we're done with the hangout. I mean, after we're done with the show. So
yeah, well. After we're done with these couple articles here, then, yeah, obviously we're not doing a trivia anymore, so.
Yeah, that's
we'll be done.
Yeah, that's what I figured.
Okay.
So just letting you know.
Okay. Oh, yeah, this one.
Game fans cannot stream online. And boy, the content creators and streamers aren't happy about it.
Yeah, after nearly a decade of waiting for the next major entry in the Persona series to arrive on the PlayStation 4 and the PlayStation 3, players in the West finally got the chance to grab a copy of Persona 5 for themselves this Tuesday following the game's release in Japan late last summer. As you might have guessed, Persona 5 has quickly climbed the charts to be one of the best Japanese role-playing experiences available. Largely due to the sheer amount of style packed into almost every aspect of the game. And the next couple articles, I believe, just like talk about the game itself. Okay. On launch day, the game's publisher, Atlas, released a set of guidelines for both video content and live stream, which is when things took a turn for the worse. The blog post outlining rules for the streaming or sharing video content for Persona 5 is a relatively harsh one compared to many other large video game releases, which often allow and encourage their players to share experiences however they see fit with their audiences. Essentially, Persona 5's restrictions only allow you to play through one third of the game while also telling players not to discuss or showcase boss fights, major story moments, the end of the game's palaces, and so much more. If players decide
to go for it regardless,
Sorry, someone was calling me. While also we'll meet them with content ID claims, channel strikes, or account suspensions, which has prompted many content creators to avoid posting videos or stop streaming it altogether. So basically, that's if you don't stop, then you're just gonna get shut down, you know?
Yeah. I mean, this is like, it's basically like Nintendo, where they're like, no, you can't show any fucking thing. I mean, the shit came out last summer, or, you know. You figure they'd want the hype train to go bigger. I mean, you could say Fallout 4 was overhyped because it was everywhere when it came out, but, you know.
Well, is Persona 5 more story-based? Because that's a different argument.
I believe so, yes. But, I mean, if you're going to sit and watch the entire stream, it's because you really care. I watched the Let's Play of, you know, Fallout 4 before I even bought the fucking game, and I still played up to where I'm at now. I'm a level 55, you know. So.
Yeah. But basically, I just decided to... Also, this other article talks about an expert lawyer breaks down everything you need to know in the Spectate Faker case. So this is just, I'm just mashing these together. I can read the article. It's still loading or something.
Okay, well, mine's up. I'll do it since the screen's up for everybody. Bryce Blum currently represents numerous players, teams, leagues, tournament organizers, and service providers in esports, and counsels clients on entertainment, employment, sponsorship, sports, intellectual property, development of league rules, and gaming law issues within this emerging industry. Background. The League of Legends esports scene is in the midst of a complex copyright battle involving three of the biggest parties in the space, Twitch, Azuba, and Riot. This dispute was the subject of a recent video by Travis Gafford, which did an excellent job highlighting the issues and making sure this gets the attention it deserves. I'm going to build on Travis's analysis and offer some detailed legal content to facilitate more discussion on the topic. The issues begin with a Twitch stream called Spectre Faker, which aired the raw content of Lee Faker Sang Hyuk's games through op.gg. As this stream gained in popularity, Azuba understandably got upset about what it perceived as a drain on its business. Azuba has exclusive rights to act as Faker's streaming platform through a contract it entered with Kespera. Apparently, based on this argument, Azuba filed a complaint with Twitch under the Digital Millennia Copyright Act, DMCA, alleging that Spectre Faker was infringing on its intellectual property rights. As a result, Twitch cleared the archives, highlights, and episodes from Spectre Faker and issued a 24-hour restriction from broadcasting. Basics of copyright law. I'm not going to read all that.
Read the copyright thing.
Okay, hold on. I got to go back up. Where the hell? Okay. Whoa. Under Title 17, U.S. Code 106 of the Copyright Act, copyright holders have the exclusive right to publicly perform the work and to reproduce copies of the work. However, copyright holders can grant licenses to others to use the protected work at the discretion of the copyright holder.
Okay. That's so you don't have to read anymore. So basically, I just had this to have discussion about, because there was I watched the No video. They talked about this also. And so, yeah, Twitch is coming under fire with this because, you know, like people are, this is like a very gray area because, I mean, people have been, it's a whole industry now of games, streaming your games and stuff. And the PS4 even has an option for you to stream your game, but it's actually a gray area. And technically, one lawyer was saying that Let's Plays aren't okay. You know, like streaming the games aren't cool. You know, like you could actually be DMCA'd, not just having your channel taken down. So it's, and a lot of people arguing, well, like the publishers have been supporting all this stuff, you know, because it gives them advertising or whatever, but it just right. depends on the publisher, and you're at the mercy. It's like a Wild West. They could, if they decide it's going to hurt, if the second they decide it's hurting their industry, and some publishers do think that, so it depends on the publisher. They, you're pretty much at the mercy of them, you know.
Well, that's the same thing with the Let's Players. They have that problem that if a publisher doesn't like a review, they could try and file a copyright claim, and YouTube will drop, you know, demonetize the video or pull it down or do all kinds of, or strike their account and stuff. And it's like, you know, there's no official standing that, like, you know, of course the video has helped the people making the games. It's just, you know, it's not like a movie unless you're playing a specifically story-driven game, and then that's an argument. But it's a whole matter of transformativeness. So,
transformativeness.
Yeah. The lawyer was saying that too. Like, it's not like just streaming the thing. Even if you're doing commentary, isn't like you're not transforming it that much, and it's not fair use.
Well, the fair use argument was when YouTube was going under fire with it. Then that became a lot more transparent to people because no one really knew what fair use was. It's if you actually defame or make people uninterested in the product and could hurt their sales, then it's an issue.
All right.
But as long as you're just actually commentating on it and you don't give away shit like that, then it's technically within the boundaries.
Well, it's a defense more so than anything else at that point. Because they're saying, are you adding commentary, or are you actually making parody? Are you actually saying anything, or are you just using it as an excuse to show the content?
Right.
And the one lawyer was saying, or the one guy on the know was saying, sure, you own the game disc, but you're just licensing what's actually on the disc. So it goes back to what we were talking about, the tractor and stuff. You're not actually owning any of the digital stuff, you know? And the licenses is only a protection for you, you know? Mm-hmm. You're only protected with certain things.
Okay, and I got one last story, guys.
Okay, what's that?
Parents must rat on kids for internet piracy. German court rules. Come on, let me scroll down. You motherfucker! There it goes. German's parents have to inform authorities of illegal downloads by their children. A German high court has stated in an unprecedented ruling, refusal to comply results in fines. The Federal Court of Justice BGH in Karlsruhe on Thursday ruled against a family in which the parents refused to testify against their child in a case of copyright infringement on the internet. The couple from Munich with three adult children refused to name the child who had pirated a copy of singer Rihanna's 2010 album Loud using a family computer. The father claimed that under German law, family members are protected from testifying against each other, and therefore he should not be forced to say which of his family members or which of the children was the pirate. That argument failed to convince the judge, however. Unable to force the man to point out the culprit, the judge sentenced the parents to pay Universal Music some $3,500. I don't know what they're, what is that, pounds? That's not pounds. Euros? Oh. $3,750 in damages. His reasoning was that the parents, as owners of the shared family internet connection used for the illegal downloads, can be held liable.
Mm.
Well, see, that's a different argument than being held liable. You know, it's like for that, it's like they aided to it by having the internet connection. Mm-hmm. So therefore, that's a different argument than having to rat on them. They didn't. It's not saying that you have to say which kid did it, but you are, if it's in your house, you're liable for it. Yeah, that makes a little bit more sense.
That's why also like if you're using like Wi-Fi at Starbucks or whatever, and you do that stuff, they could be held liable too, couldn't they?
Yeah, I don't know. I just thought this was an interesting story because that's some unheard of shit right there.
Yeah, that's crazy.
What?
How many different things are on there?
Oh, I got a bunch because this is a Steam app. So there's workshop stuff for it where you can download avatars that other people have uploaded.
Cool.
That's how I had Rick and Morty. I like this one because he's so expressive.
Yep. That's pretty cool. Like me? Did you say, does that look like you?
Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Is it about time for us to say goodbye for another week?
Sure. Do you have your guitar in there? You could actually do an outro.
Yeah, but it would have to be unplugged because then I couldn't talk. So hold on.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
All right, everybody there?
Yeah.
Okay. Here's one I wrote about getting drunk. Okay. Everybody, thanks for coming on. It's been fun. And we'll see you all next week. Thanks for coming on, Ben. I know it's been tough.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna play us out.
All right. Oops. Ciao, Soko.
Play us out, Guitar Cat. Oh, I love this song. Camptown Races, sing this song. Doo-dah.
Not a Soko.
Boobs. I need to learn keyboard cat on the guitar. I know it on keyboard, but I can't remember it. Okay. Well, thanks everybody. Thanks for
being here. Say goodnight to the cat.
Night, cat.
Good night,
cat. Hi, kitty.
Goodbye. Oops.
Peace out.